Hello, welcome to our reading for the middle of November 2016. So, November 11th through the 20th, I decided to format the readings in the middle of the month a little different and do it by our elemental family. So, air, earth, water, and fire. Remember, it's a general reading, so see what feels right for you. See which signs, symbols, bells, whistles, messages, energies resonate for you and bring you clarity to what you're wondering, concerned, confused, inquiring, dreaming, and praying about. We're all children of God. We're all psychic. We're not all going through the same thing at the same time, at the same pace. So see how it feels for you. It could be one sign. And that brings you clarity. It could be the whole reading. It could make sense later. It could be a different reading that you connect to. It could be a sign or a lyric in the song that I provide below. I hope you get to check those out. But in the end, always use your logic and intuition together to make sound decisions based in love for the highest, greatest good of everyone. So we're all uplifted in love. See how it feels for you, how you ride. These energetic waves that come through here is always up to you. Is it your wave? Is it not your wave? Are you waiting for another wave? Preparing for the wave? Crashing into the wave? Riding that wave or ignoring the wave? Also, feel free to make this an interactive video with me. And thank you for joining me. I love you guys, and I'll see you in a moment. Hello, welcome to our reading for Water Family. So, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, also called the Ascendant. This reading is for the middle of November 2016. So, November 11th through the 20th. Let's begin with the Life Purpose Oracle cards and see what God's Source, Holy Spirit, or Higher Self, angels and energies of love have for the highest, greatest good of all. Let's get clarity for the middle of the month for the water family, Cancer, Scorpio, and Pisces. Wisdom. Light and love. Wow, that's a beautiful card. Your purpose is to bring divine healing, light, and love into the world. Your purpose is you being here. That's what I'm getting. It's not necessarily the doing for water signs, it's being, is what I'm getting. Exuding, like, energizing your frequency, your light, your vibration, your actual energy is what's healing. Perhaps your energy is needed somewhere. You're called to go somewhere, be in a conversation, like a heart-to-heart conversation, or some healing experience that's going to happen. In the middle of the month that you're gonna feel, I feel like it was your destiny to be there to help out, to like turn on a light or follow a light or help somebody else. I feel like it's actually your energy, water signs, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, it's actually you. It's you by being you that's actually healing the situation, this relationship. I feel like for some it's environment, like you as the person in an environment that's normally a different energy. And as soon as you come in, the energy changes or balances out, or you are the calming influence in a situation that's like heated or chaos or gray, like low energy. And you can always sort of balance that, feel it out and like navigate it, navigate that energy, that emotion in the room, maybe empathy, you know, so you can maybe you have deep understanding of something somebody else is going through, even if they don't say anything. Maybe it's just you can feel feel when somebody's energy is different. Maybe you're extra sensitive. But I feel like you know how to adapt that situation, if that makes sense. So if an energy comes in, you have the antidote. You know, you have, you have like whatever energy needs to counter that energy coming through to balance it, heal it. I feel like there's sweet energy, sweet, golden, healing energy here. Trusting your heart. Perhaps there's somebody else blocking their heart, or that was you in the past blocking something, and that was blocking off your natural ability to heal situations. Maybe there was something you were working on first, or something that you went through in the past that had a pause, a break, an X. I mean, look at how, look at the hand. Can you see that? I don't know if you can notice, but her hands are like this. So she's sort of like almost like flying free or opening up or closing something in. It's an X. So it makes me think of an X, maybe releasing an X, releasing baggage, so that you can move forward with something light, loving, healing, like loving decisions I'm getting. So maybe there's something that was blocked and now that's being released. But I feel like that block or that stall or that issue or that past incident or relationship or whatever you went through, was the spark for the healing light or the book to understand that healing light. You know, it's like you got the instruction manual. You couldn't have learned it unless you went through the school. So now that you understand and you not only went to the school, but you did a little like apprenticeship with it. You had a little experience with something that you can now bring with you as a light healing energy that you understand, instead of something heavy and baggage that you're dragging with you or constantly pulling back into the picture. That's what I'm getting, but it starts with you just reading the manual, understanding what you went through, how it's bringing you somewhere else, how it's healing to you to understand something so that you're not dragging something along. That's sort of what I'm getting, but I feel like the energy you're moving towards is so free. I'm getting freedom and light, loving decisions, healing light and love to this world. I feel like it's bigger than just a relationship, although you could be watching just sort of interested in a relationship question, but I feel like it's either that this relationship that comes through or that's being healed has a bigger purpose together than apart. There's more healing, there's more people that are healed from this relationship than just the two of you or just that family or your family, or I feel like this love spreads farther than that. I'm getting like a bath that you, like a loving bath that you bathe in this light all the time, this music all the time, so it influences you all the time. Your decisions, so your reactions to things perhaps are different with this love around than they were in the past when it was heavy. It's like a change in focus. It's like turning on the light that you had blocked before. That's what I'm getting. So let's continue for water signs. I'm going to move along to the Thelema Tarot. Let's get some clarity on light and love. Your purpose is to bring divine healing light and love in this world with what you love to do. Maybe something you had blocked before, like stumbling on your own feet, You know, blocking yourself on something that you're in love with, or you love to do, and you didn't have time for, or fears about, or I see a symbol on her head. I know that's supposed to be a fan or a hat, but first I saw a symbol. So I know that's, I wanted to say a halo, but it's actually her wing. But you see how that looks there? So I'm getting rhythm, and maybe you have cymbals or percussion instruments and you haven't played and you love that, or something like that that you love to do. And that's you loving that and starting to do that is going to put you on the right trail to what you're going to be doing maybe later. Maybe it doesn't involve the drums at all, or maybe that cymbal is your symbol. You know, whatever I just said, let's get more clarity from the Thelema. On light and love for Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. And that's a Six of Cups. So, connection from the past, somebody from the past coming back, remembering a past situation, relationship. I don't know. I mean, personally, when I see the Six of Cups, I feel like if it's not somebody you knew as a child, it's somebody you met, and for some reason, whether you believe in past life connections or soul families or destiny or soulmates, it's somebody you feel like you've known, or you were supposed to know, or have known, or there is a connection deeper than the surface. There's also this dark water, but there's just like energy and light, even when it's dark underneath the stars. This relationship creates its own light. There's contentment here. There's peacefulness here. There's no strings here. I feel like it's just like children playing, free of judgment, free from time, timelessness in a way. It's balance restored, but I mean, traditionally the meaning is like maybe contentment, people from the past coming back, your children remembering the past fondly or not so fondly, like not remembering the good times, just the crappy things that happened in a relationship and forgetting about all the beautiful things you learned there, and you're dumping out, you know, all those beautiful expressions of yourself or things that you learned or how you grew. You know, sometimes we just grow with different relationships, different people. We grow up, we learn. I'm getting like maybe somebody childhood, like love, you know, somebody you had a crush on in high school or junior high, or maybe that person, somebody you thought of as, I'm getting two different things. I'm getting a group that maybe has somebody like that they thought of fondly then. It was beautiful then. It was its time then. It was a beautiful experience, but you know, you don't remember anything really bad. It was a happy little high school relationship or college or something like that. Something where you felt young, you met young, but you never want to do a redo. You know, that's done. You still remember it fondly, but if you met that person again, or you're meeting that person now, or it's somebody you know, you're not going to have a redo on that. You're going to maybe just remember how awesome it was when you were kids and how awesome your kids are now. I'm getting that. So just completely platonic, you know, talking about your kids together. For another group of water signs, so Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, I'm getting it's somebody that you connected to in the past, that you felt like you were destined to be with, or just knew, or deja vu, or, you know, something you got into fast, you know, fast like you were a kid, like you didn't know what you were getting into, but maybe you didn't pursue something with, continue something with, didn't work out with, life moved on. I mean, she looks like she's fondly, I mean, it looks like her, she's been thinking about this so long, her clothes are falling off her shoulder. She doesn't even notice. She's, you know, really into that memory. It's sparkly. There are little like sparkly, they look like fiber optics, but like, little like daffodils or like little seeds here from her thoughts of what she's thinking, these beautiful things she's remembering, but she's imagining as well, hoping things happen in the future, maybe again. Maybe she's hoping somebody comes back. He's hoping somebody comes back. Maybe a redo in some cases. But I feel like this is always some kind of connection that was just meant to be somehow. You know, maybe this is a healing situation from the past here. You know, maybe you're thinking about that thing in the past. It was dragging you along and it needs to come to the surface and be thought about a different way. You thinking about the blessings you got from it, the lessons you got, so you know what you need now is in a moment, because this card is all about like there or there and imagining beauty there and there, which is all well and good, but you have to bring back to the now and sometimes snap yourself out of it so you can remember to have some balance and experience in the now, some love in the now. So I'm still getting somebody coming back, or you going back to somebody else, or a reconnection from somebody from the past, platonic or sexy time. You know, it could be a reconnection and a retry with somebody that you had that connection with that you just can't understand, or you connected somehow effortlessly, somehow. You know, just like I get like one thing to the next, to the next, to the next, and I'm getting the past. So maybe there's been some time. Maybe some time for healing, some time for growth, some time for each of you to light your own light up. Or this is like some kind of conversation with somebody that you know from the past, and there are going to be like ideas and like lights being turned on, like memories from the past or ideas for the future, but it's bringing both of you into the now. Even though there's one person here, I feel like they're always, or there's usually two, so maybe it's just, maybe you don't know that it's happening on the other side as well. Maybe there's not that connection yet. Let's get more clarity. Let's move along to the romance angels and get clarity for Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer on the Six of Cups. It always makes me think of like reunion, redo, retry, reconsider, reconnection, reestablish something. I hear propose. Maybe this had to do with a proposal in the past, or you're thinking about proposing something to somebody in the past, or something like that is coming through, blossoming. I feel like there's just opening up here, like a lotus. So, strength in beauty and vulnerability. In opening up is where the strength and the balance is. Let's get a card for water signs. Matters of the heart, communication, love. It's safe for you to love. Open your heart to give and receive the highest energy of all. That's so much like this one, light and love. Your purpose is to bring divine healing, light, and love in this world. If that's something that you're blocking off or you were scared of before, it's time to open up. It's time to pause, stall, get off your horse, have a conversation, open up, give somebody a ride. Don't pass this by and go inside the kingdom or in the courtyard there without seeing what this is about. I feel like there is somebody apprehensive or nervous or. Wow, it's like the horse and this woman are wearing this big ass carpet, like a tapestry I'm seeing. Like something really heavy under the curtain before. Concealed, heavy, but beautiful. So maybe it's time to like lighten the load, He actually has a cape with like the same material as her. It's like they match. It's like they found their match. Something like that. So maybe it takes stopping. I'm getting directions, or I feel like there was a pause here on his behalf or her behalf. You know, somebody's sort of stalling or thinking about something for a while. Maybe it didn't work in the past. They're afraid of this going by too fast, getting into something too fast. You know, maybe they got into something in the past too fast, or had baggage in the past. I feel like it has to do with past and just releasing that, letting that go, and being light enough to get up on her horse and go, or she needs to get down to the ground and hang out. Like, she looks like she's flying by. The horse just looks like it was ready to go and saw this little fellow here and was like, "Whoa," you know, just, we have to stop here. Like, the horse knew something that maybe she didn't. So I would say don't fight nature. Get yourself grounded. If there's somebody that was, I'm also getting like somebody feeling like somebody else is like too good for them or something silly like that, and not having a conversation to find out that they're actually alike. You know, they actually have things that are connecting them. Perhaps they got ready in two different kingdoms and didn't know they'd go to the same person for their awesome tapestries that they throw on as a cape and over their horse. You know, they didn't know this, but maybe that's what the conversation's about. "Hey, I like your shoes. I like this. I didn't know you had that, and I have that." Or that taste in music, like me. Or, "I didn't even know that existed. Thank you for introducing it." It's, there is a connection that needs to be made, and there's letting something heavy go. Because I feel like this is new. This is not what you went through before. You know, it's about whatever you went through before. And if it was just an experience that you had, you now have consciousness about what you went through that worked and didn't work. So you know how far to go and what not to do, how fast to take it, and how, what to, I feel like, I don't know, like maybe it was too fast in the past and you're worried. She's moving pretty fast. He wants to take it slow. Maybe there needs to be a connection in the pace. So you need to talk about that, or open up about you know, what you like, what makes you feel safe. Maybe there's something about not feeling safe before. So maybe that was a situation before you were nervous about being open, or feeling exposed, or exposing something of the past, or worried about something, or judgments, or, you know, it's just saying, whoever this is that you're meeting or connecting with, that it's safe. Don't worry. Whoever this is that you get that, like, knowing, and you feel like there's something healing about being around them. It could just be a conversation that really helps you. You know, it's safe to open up to this person, whoever this is. It could just be a dinner conversation, a lunch conversation, or it could be a big old reconnection to redo and try the relationship again. Or it could be the connection with something from your past or your childhood with somebody completely new that brings you to this point where you realize this is actually somebody who's pretty cool like me, and it's safe. I feel like something felt unsafe before, either with this person or inside of you or in a situation, and now that's changed. There's a change in direction, there's a change in pace, there's a coming together. It's flying out of my hands, and let's get another card. All right, so let's move along to the Angel Tarot and get another card for water signs. Clarity on. It is safe for you to love, the Six of Cups, and light and love. Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces, advice, wisdom. And that's the, well, that's beautiful. That's the Nine of Raphael. That's like the Nine of Cups. That's like all your wishes that you want are right there before you, ready to come true. It's up to you to know what you wish, to know what you're getting into, to know what you really want. It's like the genie in the bottle. Know when you've had enough, know when you've said enough, know when you're feeling good in the now, And don't get ahead of yourself wanting too much at once, or it could topple over, or you could, you know, overdo it or get something you don't really want in the end. So it's all of your wishes and your desires being right here, ready to come true. It just takes you being a smart cookie to know what it is that you want, you know, to know that perfect balance of when you're good. And it's also abundance. It's when you not only have intentions that are, it's like I really like the steampunk version of this, because it's like you're walking into this establishment or place and there's all these wine glasses and drinks and this girl's like, here you go. Whatever you want, it's there. Just choose wisely. If you drink too much or overdo it emotionally in one area, too much in one thing, you know, it could feel like too much. But the 9 is completion. So it's feeling complete, knowing when you feel complete. Make a wish, dreams become reality, and it's a joyful time in life. It's when magic just comes, when you think about it. You know, when you allow it in, when you allow love in, when you make choices that allow love in, that also allow love in to your world, that you go into that room or that establishment, that party, that beach, wherever it is, and you make a wish that doesn't necessarily just involve yourself. You make sure, you know, your dog is taken care of, the people down in the beach, you know, that you saw on the way there, taken care of, anything that you can think about that is in abundance, that you can squeeze out of that bottle and that wish you're thinking about, so you get your money's worth. You know, you make sure that everybody has an abundance and not just you. You got the genie in the bottle. You might as well make sure it's a good one. So this is that kind of abundance that comes in, where it's not just you that benefits. It's everybody that benefits from you making this connection, opening your heart. I feel like it's this. It turns on some kind of light in a relationship, in you, from a conversation, from letting something go, from allowing love in, from, you know, figuring out your dreams, maybe with somebody else, that, like, I feel like it ends up to be that you do this one thing for everybody, and that was the natural secret wish that ended up making you have that wish come every day. Like, you hit that perfect ding, 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 where you said the right wish, where it actually came back even more for you, even though that wasn't really the intention in the beginning. You just sort of, you know, want to take care of yourself and everyone else. And here you go. It's time to think about what you want. All right, let's get a card from, I'm going to go to the fairy tarot for water signs. 9. It's like the 9 of water, the 9 of cups. Completion, emotion, the heart, like just feeling joyful, feeling like you can have anything you want right now. Just that emotion right now is beneficial for you to have. I feel like it's good things coming in and you're spreading that good energy around. Whatever good this is that you're, you know, getting into, this change in love, letting something in, letting something go, is lightening up your load. And I feel like just the energy everywhere you go. Yeah, let's get another sign for Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. Light and love. Safe for you to love. 9 of Raphael, 9 of Cups, 6 of Cups. This is a really nice reading. That's Manix eating on the squeaky table, just so you know, and Vincenzo's asleep. He's asleep. All right, let's get a card. And that's the Magician. So it's time to make a wish. Make some magic. Create something beautiful right around you. There's something really powerful in the energy for water signs now, where you can do what you want, change your mind about something, make a new start on something, go a different way. That's the I am one energy, the yang masculine, make it happen. It's also new. It's the magician. It's getting grounded, getting going, having a new start, believing in yourself, having all the tools in your bag from the Fool, you know, the leap of faith, but you're starting to pull those tools out and use them and see how they work, what they do. You know, I feel like you have energetic frequency that is healing. So maybe you're getting some like gifts, spiritual gifts that are coming through, and you're figuring out how to make use of them here. Like, oh my goodness, oh my God, that's real. Look at what's happening. Something special for you, a special connection for you. I feel like it's not just magic. It's spiritual. It's something really deep connecting in you. I mean, there's like this, I see like a braid. I'm seeing a braid or like an entanglement before, and you're untangling something and creating magic from something that you were tangled in before. I feel like there was something barren behind you, or you're leaving something you left pretty well established here behind, and you're taking a walk. You're going somewhere different. You're going on a new journey, and now you're at a point when you're away from whatever this was before, you know, old kingdom, new kingdom, something like that. And now look at the light sparkling around you now when you're free, and look at these flowers blossoming around your energy. There's something blossoming around you, around your energy, your magic, your love, doing what you love. All right, let's get one more card from the Winged Enchantment Oracle. This is all birds. Let's get one more card to some. This is really powerful. You're completing something with power and beauty and love and everything at your fingertips, and then getting to start something like brand new with all that strength and all those tools and all that. I hear awesome capabilities that you've learned, or just, I feel like you're free. I feel like you're free to fly. You have these translucent wings that look like you can fly any way you want to go, and you don't have much with you, just what you need. And I feel like you're not really even carrying everything. You just sort of have energy with you, and even your staff is just energy. You know, it's just the way you're bringing in that energy, bringing in that inspiration from spirit, and how you're moving it through you, and what you're figuring out around you that you need at the moment, and manifesting it just when you need it, thinking about that solution when you need it. And when the idea comes to you, you see it. It's right in there in front of you because you notice it. Hi, Maddox. Let's get one more card for Water Signs, mid-month. The Lark, that's number 19. That makes me think of singing, the sun, opportunity, the spotlight, hearing a call. She has like this thing in her hair that looks like feathers, or like, yeah, hairpiece or earrings. It's number 19, so that brings us, well, that brings us to a 10. So that brings us to an ending and a beginning. So it's definitely a transition time. All right, let's see what Lark is. Lark, I am Lark, the enduring song of the soul. I am voice. I am the wandering bard. I am everything that resonates through sound. I will teach you. I feel like this has to do with gifts. I just want to take note of that. So it has to do with speech, or it has to do with sound, what you hear, symbols, signs, how you resonate, tone, intonation, stuff like that. I feel like it's special. I don't know why I had to jump in there. Sorry if that was annoying. I wish to teach you to use words and how to make them magic. I will give you a purpose for everything you utter. I will give you a clear intent for every expression you release. Everything you say permeates the cosmos. I am the chant that awakens. I am the mantra that focuses thought. I am the love ballad and the victory song. I am here to free your voice and show you how to direct it towards your destiny. You have kept quiet. Maybe that was with the thing. Maybe you're, you know, with this. What I was getting with the cross. You have kept quiet too long. It's time to awaken your senses. Speak with clarity and intent. Express with depth and purpose. Pay close attention as your words reverberate around you. You are in tune with the cosmos. You are manifestation. You are harmony. You are lark. So it's about getting in tune with yourself, with someone else, helping somebody else get in tune, like feel alignment, get realigned. That makes me think of the body a little bit, like exercising and actually moving physically. I just get a lot of freedom here. Harmony and music, just music, writing music, playing instruments, connection with music, maybe, you know, being that point that opens up a conversation or connects you or brings you towards, you know, something you really desire. Maybe it's a musical connection here that points your path, you know, or connects you to your past, or frees yourself, frees your soul, frees your heart somehow or someone else to love again, to, you know, redo something without fear, you know, to trust the situation, the harmony in the situation, the song that comes through, the song that maybe still needs to be written. I hope this is helpful for you guys. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, I love you, and I'll see you soon.